First, there were six.
Can't keep away. Can't keep away. Can't keep away.
There was one. TWA presents the Elimination Champ.
TWA's Elimination Chamber. We are live at the Air Canada Center in Toronto, Canada. We are jam-packed over like 50,000 here in this arena. RJ Beckham alongside my broadcast colleague, Mark Adams. And tonight, Mark, many championships will be decided on the line, including the Universal Championship, as Batman would love to get his hands on Waluigi to get his Universal Championship back. And also, the TWA Championship will be decided in the Elimination Chamber. Six men, who knows who's going to come out on top?
You know, my question is, why is there a WWE logo on our table?
I don't know, maybe they forgot to replace it with TWA. But I'm just so excited. Can we just get on with the show? We will first start off with our first contest. Light heavyweight title being decided as the Bean, the current light heavyweight champion, would love to turn back the challenge of Borat Sagdiev. Of course, Bean has been ducking Borat ever since Borat tried to lay down the challenge. But since Borat won the number one contendership on the last Battlefront, Bean has nowhere to run and nowhere to hide.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA Light Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from Kazakhstan, weighing in at 228 pounds, Borat Sagdiev.
Borat, he's got his athletic wear showing that he's ready. He wants that light heavyweight title. And also to give his former friend, Bean, an attitude adjustment.
Don't you refer to John Cena's finisher.
I'm a broadcast journalist. I'll say whatever the hell I want.
And his opponent, from London, England, weighing in at 153 pounds, he is the TWA Light Heavyweight Champion, The Bean!
Bean has ditched the choir music in favor of this, I don't know, reggae song.
Ever since winning the light heavyweight title, Bean now thinks he's more hip and cool than ever. His attitude has become a turnoff for the fans, but nonetheless, he has remained successful as light heavyweight champion. Some might wonder if this new attitude has worked or not. Borat, he has been in TWA before, but he never picked up any championships. The Bean. Oh, come on! He extended his hand out to Borat, and then he kicks him right below the belt. That is uncalled for. And the Bean is just hammering with those closed fists on Borat. Oh, come on. That is disgusting. That is more disgusting than seeing Borat in that green thong he wore. Wait a minute. Borat's got the wrenching back submission hold. Can he make the Bean submit? No, he can't. I think this is just a reflex for me to call him Mr. Bean.
You know what? Just screw it. Call him Mr. Bean.
How about I just call him Bean? And Borat, working on the shoulder socket of Bean.
Oh yeah, if you remember in Borat's contendership match, he used the Vulcan neck bench on Ace and won. So he's probably trying to soften up Bean's shoulder, and look at him run away.
And now Bean, this is typical, he's trying to get himself counted out, that way he doesn't have to lose the championship. That is just pure cowardice on Bean's part. And Borat, he's not going to have any of it. Oh, bulldog by Bean.
And now Borat's mustache is all red.
Borat needs to drag Bean back into that ring if he wants to win the light heavyweight title. And Bean just tripped up. Talk about a misfire. And now the Bean, he's daring Borat to get up. He just, oh, double axe handle, and it nails right on the mark. One, no. Borat, he's not giving up yet. There may be some blood spillage from, I think it's around Borat's eyebrow. And Bean just tripped Borat right on the knees. His moveset has changed as well. He's just going for all these sneak attacks. And Bean with a scoop slam on Borat. If Borat can't build some momentum, this match will be over. Borat rams Bean right into the turnbuckle. Sends him flying right into the ring post.
Again, softening up that shoulder.
And Bean using those closed fists again. And the Bean stunner. One, two. Oh, I don't believe. Borat, I thought that was going to be it right there. There's another Bulldog. And Bean, he's just continuing to taunt Borat. Oh, and he just wrenched the back. Come on, ref, give me a break. This is like the fifth time Bean has broken the rules here. There's a scoop slam by Borat.
Well, there it is, the neck bench.
Could this be it? Is he going to get Bean to submit? Is he going to? Bean looks like he's still hanging on, though. I don't think... And I don't believe it. The Vulcan neck bench didn't work on Bean. This could be trouble. If the Vulcan neck bench couldn't finish Bean off, Borat's going to have to improvise. He's going to have to come up with plan B. And Borat, using a hammer-like fist, That could have knocked him unconscious. One. No. Borat looks like he's getting his momentum back. There's a double underhook. And he just flips him like an omelet. And there's an elbow. And now Borat, I think this is becoming more personal now as opposed to just wanting the light heavyweight title. He wants to teach Bean a lesson in manners. Borat, he's hurting. You could sense the cranium is just really hurting him. Bleeding from the right, from the left side, excuse me. There's a running power slam. Shades of the British Bulldog. And now, why is Borat going to the outside?
Big mistake. You just gave Bean enough time to recover.
I think that's a sign of Borat's ring rust. He's been away from the ring for so long that he cannot give his opponents any kind of opening. Once again, that exposed cut of Borat's just spilled right onto our announcer's table. And Bean would gladly take the win by count out if he wants. But Borat, ever the spiritual one, he comes right back in. And now Borat, he's going to go for his native camel clutch submission hold. But Bean reaches the ropes. That is just bad luck on Borat's part. Oh, double underhook suplex. If he had hooked it, he could have gone for the pin.
What are you doing? Oh yeah, that's nice. Just rip apart our table instead of going for the goddamn pin.
Oh, and Bean just knocked Borat right off the ropes. But he's quick to get back on his feet. And now, no! Borat! Oh! Just gets his jaw jacked by Bean. And now they're back in the ring. And there's another stunner. There's a pin. One, two, three. Bean successfully retains his championship.
Well, nice fucking going, Borat.
The winner of this fight is still TWA Light Heavyweight Champion, The Fiend.
Fans in Toronto not too happy about this.
I just can't believe Borat. He was so arrogant that he doesn't go for the pin. He wants to destroy our announce table like everybody seems to want to lately.
Borat was just showing guts. What do you mean?
Look what's happened. That twig is still the champion.
Well, I know Borat once again has shown signs of ring rust. He's been out of the ring for almost 3 years. Give the guy a break. We got our next matchup. It is a handicap 1-on-3 tag match as the Terminator will face the Gauntlet, taking on Homer Simpson, Count Dracula, and the most interesting man in the world. All three of these men, Mark, have axes to grind because all of these three men were relentlessly assaulted by the Terminator on past battlefronts.
And it's still unknown why Terminator has been going after everybody.
Well, Terminator, he's just made enemies with everyone on the roster.
The following contest is a 3-on-1 handicap match. Introducing first, from the future, weighing in at 351 pounds, The Terminator!
stop this man. Superman tried, and he was put out of commission for doing so. Sometimes I wonder if Terminator made the mistake of going up against these three men, or if these three men made the mistake of going up against the Terminator.
And his opponents, first from Springfield, weighing in at 266 pounds, he is the current TWA Primetime Champion, Homer Simpson!
I thought he would come out here in his Homer Hulk attire, because that seemed to work very well for him at Maximum Overdrive.
Homer has found new life into his career when he won the Primetime Championship. But now he feels more motivated than ever to go up against a computerized specimen such as the Terminator.
More like a beer. No good.
Very brave.
Good. You step over your own mother just to get one.
From wherever he wants, weighing in at 220 pounds, he has never relied on a mistletoe, the most interesting man in the world.
I still don't understand how he recovered so quickly from being thrown off the stage by the Terminator.
The most interesting man? There's a reason he's the most interesting man in the world. He finds ways to cure himself that only sick people could wish they had.
From Transylvania, weighing in at 228 pounds, Count Dracula!
I tell you, Mark, these three men have absolutely nothing in common with each other. But the one thing that brings these three together here tonight is their hatred for the Terminator. And to finally destabilize him and destroy his chip and put him out of commission for good.
If my memory serves me well, I think Terminator has also attacked Lloyd Christmas and Captain Rhodes in recent weeks, but those two didn't seem to want to get involved here.
And Homer, he's wisely starting early by blindsiding Terminator with a bulldog. Oh, and already Terminator, he's going for the termination. Dropped Homer right on his head.
Is that it?
I don't know. Why didn't Terminator go for the pin? And Homer already being sent over the ropes, he already looks like he's unconscious. Oh! Just rammed right into the guardrail and turn around. Oh! Jesus Christ, superstar. Homer sent right into the guardrail. And now, most interesting man, he has seen enough. He wants to come to Homer's aid. But I think the most interesting man is also paying the price for his efforts, too.
Everyone keeps stubbing their toe on the steel steps.
Well, they're really put together. Oh! Not for long, as Homer Simpson just tripped right over the steel steps. And now Terminator, he's going to send Dracula in the hard way. He's welcoming a fight with these three men. Terminator goes for the elbow. I think he just smacked Homer Simpson with that fist. Homer's already cut and bloodied open. And there's a termination for the second time. Oh, please, Terminator, just make the pin. One, two, three. Homer has been pinned, and Terminator wins the match. But that's not even enough for the Terminator. Just further injured Homer Simpson. Homer, he's having a hard time getting up. Terminator just easily disposed of Homer Simpson, Dracula, and the most interesting man in the world in under 2 minutes.
Hold on. The most interesting man and Dracula didn't even get involved.
And now, most interesting man, he's just leaving Homer.
Well, he's fed up, and I think I understand why. Homer could have tied one of them in when Terminator threw him back in the ring.
Well, still, that's no excuse to walk out on him.
That's strange. We have the women's champion coming out first. Even though Katniss Everdeen, the challenger, is supposed to make her way out first.
Yes, we have that scripted in stone.
Nonetheless, regardless of the order, we got women's championship action coming up right now.
Where's Katniss? Metal Queen is awaiting her opponent.
It looks as though the beating my servants gave Katniss made her change her mind. She does not want to fight me anymore. She chose blood.
Oh, there's Katniss! But she's sporting a bad arm. Is Katniss Everdeen gonna be in any condition to go into this match against Metal Queen?
The ring announcer didn't even get to speak.
I think we still may get our women's championship match right here, right now. We just need a referee. The match is on. Katniss Everdeen, bad arm and all. She's still going to give it a shot. Oh, and she just smacked Metal Queen right down with a clothesline. And that enrages the current women's champion.
that's kind of dumb, having a bad arm and going for a clothesline first.
Oh no, and now Mail Queen, she's just grabbing Katniss Everdeen. Oh, it just dumped her right on her neck. That's pretty near to that bad shoulder.
That neck may be broken in half.
Oh, Metal Queen, she's just continuing to hammer Katniss Everdeen with those closed fists.
Her face may be broken in half.
Will you stop? Metal Queen, she just... Oh, Electric Champion won! Oh. I think Metal Queen wasn't able to hold on to it. Therefore, she couldn't get the 1-2-3. But wait a minute. Is Katniss still showing life yet? Hurricanrana! There we go! Beautifully done! She tried to go for another clothesline, but Metal Queen knew where she was in that ring. There's a Hurricanrana. Katniss could possibly go for her first women's championship here tonight, or will she just be another victim of Metal Queen and her tyrannical reign? Katniss Everdeen so far has the momentum in her corner, but she can't get too overzealous. She has to come up with an exact game plan to battle someone like Metal Queen, because she is tough. Metal Queen didn't become women's champion for nothing.
And she's held on to that title for a good few months. When was it she won it? Like February?
I think it was January, possibly. Of course, there are some people out there who still believe that Sarah Connor, who was put out with an injury, is the real women's champion. Because she was never pinned nor submitted.
Well, we won't see her again for another few months.
Connor is still recuperating at home from that injury she suffered back in December. And Metal Queen just tackled Katniss. One. Katniss Everdeen ran to the corner. She tried to go for a Stinger Splash, but Katniss blocked it. And Katniss... Oh, Metal Queen almost ran into the referee. Who knows if that would have been a disqualification right there. Oh!
That goddamn referee's always getting in the way.
There's an inverted DDT by Katniss Everdeen, but she's still favoring that bad arm. If Katniss Everdeen wants to make her offense be useful in any capacity, she's got to use other areas of her body besides that bad arm. She's only going to aggravate it. And she just slams Metal Queen's face right into the canvas. And there's the camel clutch submission. There's nowhere for Metal Queen to go. Or maybe not. One. Katniss is still showing life yet. Although, how much farther can she get the shoulder up? If she wants to break the pinfalls, she'll probably have to kick out. There's a pin. One. Oh, and there's a slap using whatever is left of that arm. And there's a Mockingjay moonsault. Could this be it? Here's the pin. One, two, no. That close, that close. What an amazing underdog story it could have been with Katniss winning the title right there. But as is the often cliched word in wrestling by Yogi Berra, it ain't over till it's over. And Katniss Everdeen wants to make it over, but no. Metal Queen has grabbed Katniss's face and wrenches the back. There's the pin. One, two, three. Damn it. Katniss gave it a try.
The winner of this fight, and still TWA Women's Champion, Metal Queen.
Katniss Everdeen gave it the best shot that she could, but even her best was not enough. Metal Queen has that innate mean streak that she has that keeps her as the women's champion. But you gotta wonder, had it not been for Katniss's bad arm, had she not been attacked by Metal Queen's henchwoman, she might have won this match. Oh, come on! This is ridiculous! What right does Metal Queen have to attack Katniss Everdeen like that? She only won the match! I mean, come on! What a pissed off sore winner she is! And coming up next, folks, this match is personal. Two men from the dark side. Well, one allegedly from the dark side. Legs taking on the Stalker. And this whole issue arose when the Stalker first attacked Legs and only elevated further when Legs went after the Stalker's brother, Nazareth.
And they're all arguing about who's dark and who's not. I really don't give a damn.
The following contest is scheduled for Redfall. Introducing first, from the shadows of Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 240 pounds, Legs.
He is getting a very, very negative reaction, and it's probably due to the fact that he's from Boston, and you remember, Boston just beat Toronto in the NHL playoffs in that humiliating 4-1 to 5-4 loss.
Oh, please don't remind me of that. This guy needs psychiatric help, seriously.
And for some reason, he's grabbing a microphone.
I don't think this guy should be in any position to talk anymore.
I want to say something before our match begins. I just know that after what happened last Battlefront, that Nazareth is going to try and help the Stalker beat me. And on the other hand, I want to really hurt and dismember the Stalker. So I have requested that our match be held inside the chamber.
What?
As soon as he enters this ring, you guys lower that chamber immediately.
It's beginning to thunder.
Thank you.
and his opponent from Death Canyon, Arizona, weighing in at 275 pounds, The Stalker!
Stalker, will he make Legs wish that he was dead, or will Legs finally establish himself as a tried and true member of the Dark Side?
It's like they're fighting over nothing.
What, like Chris Jericho and Fandango are doing on Raw right now?
There you go again with your Fandango rants.
I'm sorry, Mark. I just can't stand the guy. That is the absolute low light of professional wrestling when that guy is getting over.
Is that really the type of thing we should be talking about while the Stalker makes his entrance?
Now the chamber, which was supposed to be used for our main event here tonight, has been lowered into the ring at the request of Legs. How he got into any power position or creative control of the company to request something like this is beyond me.
Well, at least we're still not overkilling it like WWE.
And here we go. Legs kicks the Stalker. Well, since the chamber is put into place, I'd like to point out with this match, there is no countouts and no disqualifications. The only way to settle this between these two men is by pinfall or submission. And Legs is thrown on the outside rails. And Legs just smashes the Stalker right into that steel fence. Could be worse. What if they ram each other right into the plexiglass? Yes, they did. That's not going to do that cut on Legs' throat any favors. And did Legs rip some of his hair out?
He's always ripping his hair out. You never noticed?
No, I didn't know he was gonna go all Mankind on us. It Legs with a DDT on the Stalker. Now Legs going for a top rope maneuver. Is he gonna take him to the top of the turnbuckle, or is he going to try to take him to the top of the glass? Oh! Legs lands the drop kick.
Because Legs' legs are so long, he can keep his opponent a fair distance away from him.
Also, I think those big feet can also commit massive damage.
He's like Dulcine.
Except can he stretch his arms and legs out that far? Does he breathe fire? Somehow I doubt he has the ability to teleport. Another Stalker. Oh, that knee.
Well, he may not have the ability to teleport, but he does have the ability to become invisible because he's ignored by society.
Stalker is no stranger to the Elimination Chamber. He has fought inside this structure before.
And didn't he win it last year?
Yes, he did. And legs, using those massive feet and toes. Oh, just kicked full force the Stalker's head. One. Stalker gets the shoulder up. And now Stalker, he's got legs by the slit throat. And the Stalker, really getting a positive response from the Toronto crowd. And here's the Dark Spirit. Oh! He could put him away right now. All he's got to do is pin. One, two, no! And now Stalker throws legs back onto the guardrails again. He's saying it's time to end this. And he throws legs right back in. Leg drop. There's a sidewalk slam. Stalker looks like he's zeroing in. Where is he going? Going to the top turnbuckle. Oh, he tried to go for a top rope clothesline, but legs got out of the way. I don't think the Stalker was able to connect properly with that top rope maneuver. He didn't scout legs appropriately enough. And oh! There's another suplex. Oh! Stalker tried to go for the choke, but legs poked him right in the eye. And the Stalker just gorilla pressed and threw legs down like a bag of chips. This is a choke slam. Oh! He's put him down before. One, two, three. That's it. Stalker proves his superiority. He's the one true member of the Dark Side.
Here's your winner, Boss.
It's Nazareth. He just came down from the top of the glass and draped his foot right across legs his throat. There's the vengeance. This is for revenge on what happened to him last Battlefront. Legs is busted open. Stalker finally dismissed Legs as the poser that he is. He picks up the victory. And now we gotta go backstage regarding, I think, the tag team championships being decided here tonight. Let's see what's going on back there. Oh, well, there. It seems we didn't really get to meet each other last Battlefront. Bruce and I wanted to congratulate you on defeating those Nintendo guys. Even though you had help from Batman, we still congratulate you.
Thanks for the very transparent compliments, Stark.
Well, I try to be nice.
Don't think because Batman helped us win that we can't get the job done on our own.
We'd love to see you try, Smiley. Whoa, few choice words there sparred between Iron Man and Wario. we will see these two teams get it on for the tag team titles later on. But first, coming up next, Mark, this match is going to be a little personal. The Universal Championship will be decided in a ladder match between the former champion, Batman, and the current Universal Champion, Waluigi. Batman decided to cash in his rematch clause and book this ladder match, even though you have to wonder if it's a mistake on Batman's part, because now interference will be allowed.
Well, actually, Batman personally requested that if Nintendo Power interferes, the match will automatically go as a win for Batman.
The following contest is a ladder match, and it is for the TWA Universal Championship. Introducing first, the challenger from Gotham City, weighing in at 247 pounds, Batman!
I know Batman. And he's ready. He has been anxious and hungry to get that TWA Universal Championship back around his waist since he felt he was robbed of the Universal Championship thanks to Waluigi and Nintendo Power about a month ago.
His opponent, from Italy, weighing in at 219 pounds, he is the TWA Universal Champion, Waluigi!
Waluigi only got that Universal Championship around his waist because of Nintendo Power, because of Fox McCloud. That's the only reason he has that title around his waist. It's crunch time. It's time to see if Waluigi can keep that Universal Championship around his waist without the aid of Nintendo Power. And Waluigi starts it off with a clothesline. Batman, Irish whip right into the corner. And now he drapes him upside down for the Tree of Woe. I guess he decides, since Batman's chin is the only skin that is exposed, he wants to go for the mouth. Goes for the kick and a shot to the shoulder socket. Batman with a kick to the breadbasket of Waluigi. Now Waluigi replies with a kick to the breadbasket of the Cape Crusader. There's an underhook suplex. Oh, we should have known this was going to happen, Mark. Fox McCloud is at ringside.
But if he touches Batman, the match is over.
Then what was the point of having a ladder match if this is... Oh, but wait a minute! Here comes Luigi! The odds could be even here! And Luigi already catches up to Fox, and those two are going at it on the outside. Looks like it's even now. Batman now has a fair chance against Waluigi. And I think referee has actually restored order and sent both Luigi and Fox McCloud back to the dressing room. Those two will meet in the chamber later on.
But we don't know their number yet. The only number we know is that Conan is number 4.
Indeed, a very random drawing for the world champion, but nonetheless, I once again reiterate that maybe the reason Conan the Barbarian went for number four was because it's in the middle. Therefore, he's not too tired, and therefore is in good enough condition to finish all opponents.
Watts is still at ringside, sneaking around.
And Batman brings the ladder back into the ring. Here we go, Batman. Oh, Fox McCloud!
Oh, wait a minute, that should be it.
Oh, come on, no, don't let it end like this, come on! Come on, Batman, get up! Get up!
Where is the damn bell?
Batman, come on! Waluigi's trying to get the bell, but wait a minute, there's still life in Batman, and a powerbomb from the top of the ladder.
Even Batman's confused. Look, he's just standing there in amuse, or whatever.
You know what I say? Good! Let this match continue! Let this match be contested one-on-one. The person who reaches the ladder wins the belt. It's that simple. You don't need to come up with any of these stupid stipulations to make people tune in. Let that be a lesson to WWE or TNA or anybody that's doing this stuff to make a ton of money. And now, who's going to suplex first? Batman suplexes Waluigi right on the top of the ladder. Batman. Oh, just rocketed from the third rope to dive on Waluigi's prone body. And he's in a good position to grab that title. Will he do it? Oh, Batman just tripped.
No.
Batman just tripped. And, oh, wait a minute. Waluigi just destroyed the ladder from under Batman, and he's just hanging. Will he grab it? Is this it? Oh! Had Batman just been able to unhook that belt, he could have won. And there's a backbreaker by Waluigi. How close was that, Adams?
Pretty close.
Batman is bringing the second ladder in, but why did he set it up on the outside? You can't get the championship belt from there. And he just set Waluigi tripping right over the steel steps.
There's another person stubbing their toe tonight.
That has to hurt. He just threw Waluigi right on those steel steps.
But in typical Utes fashion, he got up 10 seconds later.
Well, Waluigi, he's heavily sporting those ribs, though. You have to wonder if it is taking its toll. Either way, I don't think any man here will be the same after this match. Oh, and I think Waluigi just had his ribs rammed right into that table. Batman is going to set the ladder up once again.
Waluigi doesn't know where he is.
Waluigi a little disoriented. I think he was just playing possum to lure Batman on the outside. It's anybody's game now. Waluigi just draped Batman's head, guillotined it right on the third rope. That ladder is still set up right on that ring post. Batman setting it up. But Waluigi, he's still up. Batman, he's got to worry about Waluigi. Try to get that belt. He does! That's it! That's it! The title is back on Batman's waist.
The winner of this fight, and once again, TWA Universal Champion, Batman!
Batman is now a two-time Universal Champion. He finally proved over Waluigi that he is the better man. Batman going to the top of the ladder to celebrate his title victory, and the fans in Toronto are giving him a standing ovation. Oh, wait a minute! Waluigi just threw the ladder from underneath Batman, and Batman just lands on the table on the outside. Are you kidding me? What kind of sportsmanship was that on Waluigi's part?
Batman's getting back up and Waluigi's running to the back.
He better be afraid. You won't try to double cross Batman like that. And Batman, he comes back and stomps the living piss out of Waluigi.
Well, that armor must be really strong, because that fall must not have affected him.
Batman, he's just a man. He's tough to beat. You try to pull one on him, he will attack you and strike you back. That's all I have to say about that.
What happened? I told you to put in that stipulation I asked for last Battlefront! So why did the match not stop when Fox interfered?
Ow. Whoops. I forgot about that. But why are you upset? You won the championship back!
Damn job, Trump!
I don't understand on Batman's part. He's the Universal Champion, so he should be happy that he won it back fair and square.
You know what I don't understand? Why did he sound like Christian Bale?
Maybe he has laryngitis. I don't know. Coming up next, folks. Tag team belts are going to be decided on the line as the Avengers, who had won the tag team championships at TWAmania 4, will take on the new team of Wario and Link.
And due to some stupid new tradition, the tag team champions will always come out first from now on.
Well, I don't know why that's happening, but nonetheless, let's get on with the show.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA TV Tag Team Championship. Introducing first, at a total combined weight of 689 pounds, they are the TWA TV Tag Team Champions, Iron Man, Incredible Hulk, The Avengers!
Why does the ring announcer have to tell us who they are? We know who they are.
Well, I think the reason the ring announcer is introducing them individually is because individually, these men can find great success. I mean, the Incredible Hulk, everyone knows who he is on his own. He's a three-time World Heavyweight Champion. And Iron Man is one of the new promising upstarts here in the industry.
And amazingly, he's in the chain of the tube already. He's got around 10 or 12 points.
And you gotta think the Incredible Hulk is a shoo-in to get into that tournament.
Oh yeah, I think he's number 4.
And their opponents, the challengers, at a total combined weight of 477 pounds, Wario and Link!
Link has had an outstanding reputation in different wrestling federations, including No DQ. But can he parlay his success from the outside federations into an awesome TWA career? Link and Wario have both joined forces with a common goal: to destroy Nintendo Power, but also, as for extra incentive, they would like to get those TWA tag team titles around their waist. And we're going to have Link and Iron Man starting things off. That's the way you start it. Put the two technical wrestlers in the ring with each other. And then later, you can bring out the beef in Wario and the Hulk. Iron Man and the Hulk have not made one single title defense since they won the tag team championships at Elimination. So you have to wonder if they're going to have the poise of experienced tag team competitors.
Nice burp, RJ.
Oh! The Incredible Hulk's near 300-pound weight just crashed on Link. You have to wonder if he had crushed Link's ribs right near to his heart. That one. Jesus.
And he needs hearts. Those are the things that tell how much health he has.
Well, I gotta tell you, Link better have some lamp oil, rope, or bombs on him right now if he wants to gain the advantage over the giant of the Avengers tag team, the Incredible Hulk.
And if he doesn't, then he'll have to come back when he's a little richer.
And there's Iron Man with an elbow. Iron Man already has the advantage over Link thanks to that huge splash by the Hulk. It is my advice that Link should make the tag to Wario. The idea is to keep the fresh man inside. That's why you see frequent tags.
Wow.
And Link tags in Wario. If I were to go with who would be the freshest in each man's team, I would have to go with Link and Iron Man, because those two are carrying a lot less body weight. Therefore, they can stay fresh in that ring for long periods of time. Whereas Wario and the Hulk, they will probably run out of gas after 20 minutes.
Well, the thing is, Iron Man's carrying that, he may be light, but he's carrying that big clunky suit. And I think that suit adds about 60 pounds to his real weight.
Well, Iron Man gets by. He knows how to control the weight of his suit. One, but Wario gets the shoulder up. I would love to see Wario and the Hulk clash.
Oh, by the way, RJ, you got anything to say about the infamous twist from Iron Man's latest movie?
Oh, please. What would possess writers to come up with a twist as ridiculous as that?
I thought it was rather clever.
Will you be serious?
And now we got the Incredible Hulk and Wario. Oh. The irresistible force meets the immovable object, and it looks like the Hulk is going down. Oh! And Wario put his foot almost near to the throat. You have to wonder if the referee would have taken notice of that. Hulk clips the knee of Wario.
Wah!
And Wario gets thrown onto the outside. Both of these teams haven't been together for very long. So you have to wonder if it's a little bit even. Even though the odds always lie in the favor of the current tag team champions. Wario is rammed into the guardrail, then rammed to the ring post. Wario's in big trouble. Link has got to stand up for his partner. Wario tries to go for a kick, but Hulk stops him. The Hulk bomb.
Ay, 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 ay.
Oh, right on the outside. But he's got to pin him in the ring. Even if Iron Man and Hulk get counted out, it's no big deal. They'll still have the tag team titles around their waist. Seems neither man's able to grapple each other. It's like both of these men have oiled themselves incredibly. And we got Link and Iron Man going at it once again. Incredible Hulk with a DDT on Wario. And now, I thought he was going for a triangle choke. But instead he goes for a pin, one. I think he should have gone for the pin earlier, that therefore he would have gotten a faster count. Oh, sorry, a longer count. Now, Iron Man is being tagged back in. Launches Iron Man like a torpedo right onto Wario. Oh, and Iron Man just flips Wario like an omelet. And torpedoes himself from the third rope. Wario is in serious trouble. He needs to make the tag to Link. If he doesn't make the tag, this match could be over. Ooh. Once again, landing him on the back. Iron Man is making sure to position his pin away from Link. And that's it. Iron Man and Hulk retain their titles.
Winners of this match and still TWA TV Tag Team Champions, The Avengers.
These two men have made an excellent championship title defense. These two are for real as the tag team champions. And one of the ways you can tell they were a serious tag team, Mark, is that they were able to keep Wario and Link isolated from each other. When they kept one man apart from his partner, that was it.
Plus, Link didn't help much.
Well, Link's a little inexperienced in these waters of TWA. So it's going to take time. Wait a minute, there's Donkey Kong from Nintendo Power, and he's stomping the hell out of Wario. But Iron Man comes to Wario's aid. Good sportsmanship on the tag team champion's part.
I have a feeling that this tiny little war between Nintendo Power and Luigi's new stable has expanded to involve the Avengers.
Oh yeah, the Avengers will also have an axe to grind with Nintendo Power since they've been attacked by them several times. And now, folks, this is it. The main event. Six men competing in the Elimination Chamber match. And it is for TWA Championship. Conan defending his title against Scorpion, Luigi, Michael Myers, Fox McCloud, and the legend known as Chuck Norris. You gotta wonder though, because of the amount of participants in this match, will Conan be able to retain the championship?
After seeing him beat God, I just don't see anybody beating Conan.
The following contest is the Elimination Chamber match, and it is for the TWA Championship. Introducing entrant number one, from Cornelia, weighing in 198 pounds, Fox McCloud.
If you look up at the ceiling at the chamber, The four other participants have already climbed into their pods and are just hanging up there.
Well, Fox McCloud has the misfortune of being entrant number one, meaning he's got to await the other four competitors in the match before he can go all the way to win the world title.
Oh, this is going to be interesting.
And entrant number two, from Haddonfield, Illinois, weighing in at 256 pounds, Michael Myers!
You remember a few battlefronts ago, Fox pissed off Michael.
Indeed, he attacked both Luigi and Michael Myers, and now he has the misfortune of going up against both men in this chamber. You don't want to make Michael Myers angry. With all due respect to the Incredible Hulk, you don't want to get angry too. Michael Myers is a man who is almost rarely defeated. He did try to get a crack at the TWA Championship back in January, but he failed to get the job done. Could he repeat his mistakes here, or will he learn from them?
And the chamber is being lowered around Fox and Michael right now. We're about to begin.
The last one standing that eliminates all five men from the matchup will be the newly crowned TWA champion. And here we go. Fox goes for the kick on Michael Myers, but Michael gets right back up like it didn't faze him at all. We don't know the other numbers of the participants. All we know is that Conan will be at number four, so they don't have to worry about him at number three, which will be coming up next. Michael Myers with a suplex, and he just keeps hammering Fox. I wonder though, will all five of these competitors be gunning for the TWA champion, Conan the Barbarian? Because they know how strong he is. They know how long he has held the TWA title. And now the countdown begins.
who is going to be entrant number three.
Oh, yeah.
Entrant number three, it's Luigi. This will just keep getting worse for Fox McCloud.
Well, they may have a rivalry, but they may have to team up to get rid of that big threat known as Michael Myers.
I don't think we're going to see Luigi and Fox McCloud team up. Not after the bad blood that has boiled between these two, with Fox McCloud kicking Luigi out of Nintendo power. Fox McCloud clips the leg of Michael Myers, but I think Luigi's just sitting in the corner. But wait a minute, he chose to go after Michael Myers. I guess that shows that anything can happen here in the Television Wrestling Association. And we know, Mark, who's coming up next here. Conan the Barbarian, number four.
Oh, no.
And Conan goes right for Luigi.
Luigi looks scared.
Anybody would be frightened at the mere presence of Conan the Barbarian. Fox McCloud has been busted open at the hands of Michael Myers, and Michael Myers sends him flying. There's a pin. One, two. Fox gets the shoulder up. Entrant number five and entrant number six. It's going to be between Scorpion and Chuck Norris. Who is going to have that lucky number? Luigi clips the leg of Conan. Looks like he's finally grounded him. We got Fox working over Michael Myers. Luigi working over the reigning champion, Conan. Looks like entrant number five is Scorpion. And now Scorpion chooses to go after the big man, Michael Myers. Luigi with a bulldog on Conan. And Luigi and Fox, we thought they were going to bump into each other, but it seems they've not getting their hands on one another. If you ask me, maybe they're trying to save it to be the final two men. Now Conan, he's wrenching Scorpion, goes for a backbreaker. Luigi taking his anger and elbow out on Michael Myers. And Fox McCloud. Oh, finally, here we go. Luigi and Fox finally going at it. Scorpion jacks the jaw of Conan the Barbarian. And we all know who entrant number six is. Chuck Norris.
Ow.
Chuck, you know he's not afraid of anybody. No matter how big or small.
Oh.
And there's a roundhouse kick. Could this be the end of Luigi right here? Conan, he's actually in trouble in the corner at the hands of Scorpion. Scorpion going for the top rope. Michael Myers tried to go for a pin on Chuck Norris, but to no avail. And there's Luigi time. He's going to send Fox flying. And he goes for the pin. One, two, three. Fox McCloud has been eliminated. Chuck Norris just kicked Michael Myers full force in the head. And now Luigi, I thought he was going to go for a pin on Scorpion. Conan goes back to work on Luigi. Chuck Norris kicks Scorpion right in the face again. Clothesline of death. Oh! I think that's got to be it for Scorpion right here. One, two, three. Scorpion has now been eliminated from the chamber. Now Conan goes for the pin on Luigi, but Luigi gets the shoulder up. Chuck Norris.
With just one knee, he makes Michael bleed.
You can't spell poetry like that.
And Conan the Barbarian, he's really ramming Luigi, and a spine buster. A roundhouse kick. He's probably knocked Michael Myers out. Conan goes for the pin on Luigi. And I think Luigi has been eliminated. And from the looks of it, Michael Myers has been eliminated. We're now down to the final two men already. Conan, Chuck Norris, who's going to walk out with the title? Conan's going for the pin. One, two, oh! Can Conan break the undefeated streak of Chuck Norris here? Conan with those roundhouse kicks, looks like they're phasing the reigning champion. Oh, moonsault.
I think Hogan versus Andre has just been outdone.
Chuck Norris, another roundhouse kick, knocks Conan right off his socket. One, two, no! That close. Chuck was just 2 3/4 away from becoming the world champion. Oh, and he just leapfrogs Conan the Barbarian. What is he doing? Chuck, don't do it. Oh! That could be a fatal mistake on Chuck Norris's part. Chuck shoves Conan off. There's a kick. Oh! And I think that was a frontal moonsault. Oh, Conan looks like he's coming back. And a tackle. Chuck Norris jacks Conan's jaw. You can't really tell who has the momentum here. And Conan's being thrown on the guardrails. Oh, Chuck tried to go for a moonsault, but he botched it. That's a botchamania moment right there. One.
I didn't think Norris could botch.
I thought Conan was going to get the win off of that mistake there, but Norris is still hanging in there.
I'm blaming this on Yoops too.
Oh! I think that was almost a fisherman suplex. No, sorry, it was a tiger suplex. Conan throws Norris all the way down to the guardrails, and Conan... Oh, he just dives on Chuck Norris, but I think Norris put his knee up. Oh, Chuck Norris, it's like he's going in fast forward. One, two, no!
You need something to drink, RJ.
Almost. Conan, he's all dazed. What is Chuck Norris thinking right now?
Well, he's tried the roundhouse and the clothesline of death. What more does he have to try?
Oh, Conan with a suplex. And I think the crowd in Toronto is actually on Chuck Norris's side. One, two, no! Norris just got the shoulder up in time. There's a kick. Conan. He's not moving. That is uncharacteristic for this man. Now, Chuck, another roundhouse kick. He's just waiting for Conan to get up. And I think here's a third. Oh, maybe the fourth. And Chuck Norris goes for the pin. One, two, three. Oh, no, no. Oh, my God. I thought it was that close. That fucking close. Oh, underhook suplex.
Conan may have kicked out, but I think this is it for him. He's barely gotten any offense in.
Oh, top rope moonsault by Chuck Norris. Conan's not moving. Conan the Barbarian finally gets up, but there's those punches. You could sense that fist coming out of Chuck Norris's beard. Oh! He just sent Conan almost flying 360. And now he's busted open. And and a fifth roundhouse kick. There's the pin. One, two, three. I don't believe it. Chuck Norris has won the TWA Championship.
Jesus Christ.
The winner of this match and new TWA Heavyweight Champion, Chuck Norris.
I can't believe it. Of all the men that could end Conan the Barbarian's championship reign, it is the legend known as Chuck Norris. He only debuted a few months ago, and he just beat Conan's meteoric rise. This has got to be one of the most memorable moments in TWA history.
Yeah, you make a good point. Conan used to hold the record for the fastest rise, but now Norris does.
Congratulations are in order to Chuck Norris for being the new TWA Heavyweight Champion. Somehow, I think this man's going to have a long championship reign ahead of him.
Wait a minute.
It's Barack Obama! And it looks like he's going to cash in his bank heist, even though he's prevented from doing so back in Kentucky.
And for some reason, his briefcase now looks like a toy.
Hold it! Hold on a second! Oh, what is it now? Mr. President, why would you want to cash in now? We have just crowned a new world champion for the first time in 8 months. Can't you let Mr. Norris enjoy this for at least a week? I'll do this. I'll arrange a match for you on the next Battlefront. It will be Mr. Bank Heist Obama versus Chuck Norris on Battlefront next week. Looks like Barack Obama will finally get his championship opportunity to cash in his bank heist when he goes one-on-one with Chuck Norris on Battlefront next week. Boy, Mark, I gotta tell you, what an elimination chamber that was. Barack Obama, though, doesn't seem too pleased. He wanted to make his mark here tonight at the Air Canada Center in Toronto and win the TWA Championship. I don't know if he has any more patience to deal with this. We want to thank you for joining us, everybody. RJ and Mark Adams signing off.